Good morning, Standard 9 students. Again, today I'm going to just explain the scroll written in the silver casket. Okay. Understand this? The fire seven times tried this. Means for the purification of silver, it has to go into the furnace or a test of fire. Seven times. Only then it is considered pure. Then seven times tried that judgment is. Now I told you before, the judge gives his verdict or jump into conclusion as to the guilty should be punished or not, or the person to be proved guilty, he has to think seven times. And only seven times, after thinking seven times, that judgment cannot be proved wrong. Okay. Now, then it says, that did never choose amiss, means that kind of decision cannot be proved wrong. Some they be that shadows kiss. Okay. Now, what he meant was, some people, they embrace illusions, believe in what is not. Means, like I told you, the casket, this lottery system was based on love, marriage. Okay. But the Prince of Morocco and the Prince of Aragon, they deviated from the main theme. So they began to read or analyze or think about it in a materialistic manner, the value of the wealth, of the metal. So they were making illusions of something what is not supposed to be there. That means they were in the wrong track. Then it says, such have but a shadow's bliss. Okay. Now shadow's bliss means only the illusion of happiness. Some have got a habit of only thinking about the positive or the happiness part of life. See, when you are making any kind of a judgment, okay, you got to read and understand the pros and cons of everything. You can't only see a one particular side or one particular topic. So the illusion of happiness is there, but that should not be considered as one of the most important part, because remember, the scroll is explaining now. Silver signifies conceit, vanity, selfishness. A person who has airs and graces about himself, thinks very high of himself. Okay. And then, such have they be fools alive. I wish. Okay. Certainly, or perhaps no, that silver doer, and so was this. Okay. Now, he says, you are a fool. Now remember, when you try to trick somebody, then they say, my hair has not turned grey or my hair has not turned silver for no reason. It is silver or grey due to experience. So he said, but beneath those silver hair or beneath that You thought you were very intelligent, but actually you were very stupid. You are nothing like a blinking idiot. Because they had deviated from the main theme. The lead casket was dull. The lead casket had her portrait. So here, both these suitors were, you could say, money-minded, because they were looking at the value of these metals, the quality of these metals. Then where was Portia supposed to be? That is what it says. You were concentrating more on the metal, not on the person whom you have come to marry. So that is what he says, wherever you may go, this will remind you that beneath those silver hairs, he says, the prince, you will always be remember, you will always remember that what a fool you have been, that you were in the wrong track. You should have thought about the girl whom you want to marry. So you should have put all the materialistics, or maybe all the value of the gold and silver aside. You should have gone for the lead. Well, that inscription says you have to give and hazard all ye have. Whatever you have to take a risk. That was very threatening. But that was the right. Now after the Prince of Morocco chose the golden casket, Portia's picture was not there. So we come to know that the golden casket is not the right casket. The second suitor, the Prince of Aragon, he chose the silver casket. There also we find that the key or the portrait of Portia was not present there. So now the readers, Portia and the rest, they all know that the right casket that has Portia's picture or portrait is in the lead casket. Except now when Bassanio comes, then we come to know whether he is aware of which is the right casket. Okay. So now the Prince of Aragon realized that what a fool he had been and how he used to have a very high opinion about himself. Now he has come to know his true status. Okay, he was nothing but a stupid fool. And now he did not want to linger here. He didn't want to spend more time over there, because all the more he will be feeling ashamed that he is nothing but a fool in front of all these wonderful ladies or the people around, or in fact his own train, his own attendants were there. So he decided that he should leave immediately. Okay. And then he only passes a comment that I came with one fool's head, now I'm going back with two fools' head. Then remember the comment passed by Portia. These are all important things that I'm explaining. What did the Prince of Morocco say when he saw the lead casket? Or when he saw the silver casket? Or when he saw the golden casket? What did the Prince of Aragon say when he saw the lead casket, when he saw the silver casket, when he saw the golden casket? Okay. What comment did he pass? Now what comment did Portia pass when the Prince of Morocco failed to choose the right casket? What did she say after his departure? What comment did Portia say after the departure of the Prince of Aragon? Now these are all small but important lines that has to be remembered. Okay. So then the arrival of Bassanio has been explained by one of the servants, and Portia was in a good mood. Even when the Prince of Morocco chose the wrong casket, she said, let more of his kind come and choose. She was so happy, now she is wanting that all the dark-skinned people should come and choose the wrong casket. That was a joke which she passed, just to excite her happiness. Like, thank God he chose the wrong casket. Okay. So now I think this should be enough. And then again in the next class, I'll see which areas are important. I will explain that. Today you have your class test at 7:30 p.m. from Act 2, Scene 9. Okay. Thank you.